Professor Wen Sui, who is the head of Department of Hepatology, University of Medicine, Medicine 2. And she is also a vice president of the Myanmar Jibai, Myanmar Liver Foundation. Also, she is a patron of the Myanmar, an EC member of the Myanmar GI and Liver Foundation. She is very active academically, and she is now currently involved in many liver walks as well as COVID-19 walks. Wen Wen Sui will be talking about emerging trend in epidemiology of NAFLD and long-term outcome. Professor Wen Sui, please.
Thank you, Piazzi. Good evening, my professor, senior and junior colleagues. Today, I will talk about the emerging trend in epidemiology of NAFLD and long-term outcome. Introduction. Non-aquatic liver disease has emerged as the most prevalent liver disease worldwide, mainly because of the massive paraglobal increase in obesity. Extended public health and political efforts will be needed in the near future to counteract this disturbing development. Traditionally, obesity and its related disease have been considered a problem in Western countries. In the past two decades, urbanization in many Asian countries has led to a sedentary lifestyle and overnutrition, setting the stage for the epidemic of obesity. The term NASH was coined in 1989. After another decade, it was recognized that NASH is a part of the clinical pathologic spectrum of NAFLD. The definition of the NAFLD, accumulation of the fat within the liver, hepatic steatosis, with no other known cause of hepatic fat accumulation. There is no evidence of excessive alcohol use. This means men 3 drinks per day, women 2 drinks per day. And it is defined by the imaging or biopsy of the liver. Fatty oil can be found in non-obese individuals also. And this fatty has a lack of the secondary cause of the hepatic fat accumulation. This means significant alcohol consumption, lambda use of the steatogenic medication, or monogenic hereditary disorders. But this is commonly associated with the metabolic comorbidities such as obesity, diabetes mellitus, and dyslipidemia. Nephali is histologically into non-aquatic fatty liver, NAFL, or non-aquatic steatohepatitis, NASH. NAFL means the presence of 5% of the hepatic steatosis without evidence of hepatocellular injury in the form of hepatocyte ballooning. NASH means presence of 5% of hepatic steatosis and inflammation with hepatocyte injury, example, ballooning with or without any fibrosis. For defining advanced fibrosis, referring especially to stage 3 and 4, that is basically fibrosis or cirrhosis. NAFLD in Asia and Western country. Prevalence of the NAFLD in the Western country and Asia country, the same, 25%. A proportion of the NAFLD patients with the NASH difference in the Western country 20 to 30%, in the Asian country 10 to 20%. According to the proportion of NAFLD patients with F3-4 steatosis in the Western country 10%, in the Asian country 3 to 5%. Prevalence of NAFLD in subject with the BMI less than 20%, in the Western country 10%. Asian country 7 to 19%. Currently, the population prevalence of NAFLD in Asia is around 25%, like many Western countries. While hepatocellular carcinoma and end-stage liver disease can lead to the NAFLD remain comet, a rising trend has emerged. Around the 8 to 90% of Asians with body mass index less than 25 kg per meter square are also found to have Nefertiti. This condition often classified as lean or non-obese Nefertiti. Although this condition is generally less severe than that in more obese patients, steatohepatitis hepatitis and fibrin disease are well recognized. Global prevalence of the overweight and obesity is 39%, and global prevalence of the NAFLD is 25%, showed by 2019 haptologs. Central obesity, insulin resistance, and weight gain are major risk factors and genetic predisposition, such as the PNPL3 polymorphism, appears to be more important in the development of Nefertiti in the non-obese population. Lifestyle modification remains the cornerstone of management for obesity and Nefertiti, but few patients can achieve adequate weight reduction, and even fewer can maintain their weight in the long run. Recent events in chronic hepatitis B and C therapies, combined with increasing prevalence of obesity epidemic and other metabolic disorders such as type 2 diabetes mellitus and hyperlipidemia, has led to the dramatic rise in Nefertiti. So today, Nefertiti is a major global health problem and has emerged as the second most common indication for liver transplantation in the USA, and is projected to become number one soon. Recent events in chronic hepatitis B and C, and also the increased prevalence of the obesity and metabolic syndrome, and sedentary lifestyle, poor dietary habits, overnutrition, and advanced age can cause a dramatic increase in the Nefertiti. If the patient with the Nefertiti, this may cause the NASH, cirrhosis, liver failure, and hepatocellular carcinoma, which lead to the need for the liver transplantation. As noted previously, due to the growing obesity epidemic now affecting more than 1.9 billion adults globally. According to the recent estimate, Nefertiti affects as many as 1 billion individuals throughout the world. Similarly, in the USA, Nefertiti affects nearly 80 to 100 million individuals, making it the number one etiology in chronic liver disease. Nearly 25% of patients with NAFLD progress to NASH. However, the true prevalence of the biopsy-proven NASH is difficult to determine, as the majority of the NAFLD patients do not undergo a biopsy. Although the prevalence of Nefertiti is increasing throughout the world, there appear to be significant geographical variation. The global prevalence of Nefertiti is currently estimated to be 20%, and global distribution in the Middle East area, 32%, South American, 31%, Asia, 27%, USA, 24%, Europe, 23%, and Africa, 14%. Due to the increased prevalence of NAFLD, the prevalence of NASH is expected to increase as well. The proportion of NAFLD cases that progress to NASH will increase from the 20% to 27% by the 2030. Similarly, the incidence of the decompensated cirrhosis is predicted to increase by 168% from 39,230 cases annually in 2015 to 105,430 cases in 2030. The prevalence of Nefertiti continues to increase, and it is expected that NASH, related end-stage liver disease, will become the leading increasing to liver transplantation over the next several decades. The crossing value of NASH cirrhosis on liver transplantation is expected to increase by 59%. There are numerous studies. According to the numerous recent studies, NASH-related cirrhosis is the most rapidly growing indication for liver transplantation in the USA. In 2017, using the data from the UN Network of UNOS database, reported as 162% increase in liver transplantation secondary to NASH from the 2003 to the 2014. While the liver transit due to the acquired liver disease and hepatitis C infection only increased by 54% and 33% respectively. As the burden of NASH rating as the liver disease on the waitlist continues to rapidly grow, and the risk of the waitlist removal secondary to the death or progression of the comorbidities increase. There are so many long-term outcomes in the nephrology. There are some are good outcomes and some are the bad outcomes. Good outcomes, a NASH resolution can be achieved by the targeted weight loss by diet, physical exercise, pharmacological treatment, and surgical intervention. Nephrology without significant fibrosis can regress completely. Many bad outcomes are liver-related causes and non-liver-related causes. NASH is the risk of the liver failure, liver fibrosis, cirrhosis, and hepatocellular carcinoma. Hepatocellular carcinoma is risk are advanced fibrosis, higher age, family history of ACC, lower serum albumin, higher WBC, insulin treatment in diabetes mellitus, and chronic viral hepatitis infection. Non-liver-related outcomes. Cardiovascular risk and complication, they are very common by the complication of the nephrology. Cardiovascular disease like the myocardial infarct, stroke, influenced by the both genetic and environmental diet. Obesity-related complications like obstructive sleep apnea syndrome, and also have the increased risk of developing diabetes mellitus and closely related to degree of glucose intolerance. Another outcome is the hyperuricemia, chronic kidney disease, and gallstone disease. And also very common disease is the polycystic ovarian syndrome, and also have the colorectal adenomatous polyp and colorectal cancer. And there are the so many summarized as my topic is number one is nephrology is very common in the next few years, and there are the many complications and many outcomes. And it is currently population prevalence on nephrology is 25%. And also today, nephrology is a major global health problem and has emerged as the second most common indication for liver transplantation in the USA, and is projected to become a number one stone. And there are many long-term outcomes. Nephrology has a good outcome and also many bad outcomes. And thank you very much and attention very for your kind attention.
CFAM, caring for well-being.